Are we getting paid or not?
Any loss of productivity will be deducted from your pay.
Power's out, but I can't just leave my goods unattended. Don't suppose you'd care to do business?
Go right ahead.
What, you mean Edgewater? That's a peculiar question. This a test. Am I being tested right now? It's, fine and dandy. Couldn't be happier. Wouldn't want to spend my life working anywhere else. Prettiest little town on Terra 2. You are condescending to me, and I do not care for it. I am lucky to have my work, lucky to be alive. I don't get paid for banter. Was there something you needed?
Go right ahead.
Plague? I don't know anything about a plague. We are the very picture of hot-blooded physical vigor. I take umbrage with your choice of phrase. We ain't sick, we're rugged. Some of us who get sick are liable to exaggerate the conditions of that sickness, but the fact is, if you work hard, you have got no cause to worry. Spend enough time in the Spacer's Choice family, and you will come to understand. Medical treatment is commensurate with our value to society. Spacer's Choice will dispense medicine for the indispensable worker. Natural selection at work. Then the hand of medical science will not grace you with its touch, and you must recover on the virtue of your own grit. Listen, you mind if we talk about something else? Rambling about company policy gets me feeling all lightheaded.
Thank you.
Open the door.
Not a chance. The last thing we need is for everyone to get sick at a time like this.
I can't possibly cut anyone's hair in the dark. Go ahead. Edgewater has been good to me. I consider myself privileged to work here. I am never wanting for work, not since the plague started. The plague's come at us with a vengeance this year. Lost 6 workers in as many months. I wouldn't call them good workers, mind you. If they were any good, they'd have been treated. Still, it is a shame. Company policy, friend. We don't have enough medicine to treat all of us, so we treat the best among us. Nature is monstrous, friend, and this plague is natural selection at work. I do for you? Oh? Am I in the company of a fellow doctor? You may think that, but the tidiness of my fellow worker is my responsibility, alive or otherwise. Whether you're showing up to work or... Go ahead.
Make that face. What happened at the thermal plant? I was working on Clancy... on the loader here. And everything shut down. Oh, gosh. I didn't want anybody to lose their power. I knew folks on both sides. Mr. Thompson must be beside himself. If we could all just get along, maybe things wouldn't have got so bad. Only with every part of my body! Was that rude? We don't leave town much anymore. When I was little, I used to wander all over. Oh, you know, wild canids and marauder gangs, lava flows and crashing ships. We should be fine together, though.
Thank you.
Adelaide was right to leave.
When I was little, we'd get freighters in every Sunday noon. Now they only come...
Thank the law. I've been requisitioning backup for months. Guess the boss finally came to his senses. You ever swung a truncheon? Let me see your rifling stance. I want to make sure you're up to snuff. I'm talking about mechanical soldier. Cold, heartless automatons made of iron and lies. That's right. That's what I've been saying. We gotta square our shoulders and stand ever vigilant. Auto-mechanicals. Creatures forged in the fires of malevolence. I seen them over by the old power plant. Clattering about, firing at the birds, orchestrating their uprising. When the swarms of mechanicals come clanging on over that hill, where will you be? Cowering beneath your cot, or standing shoulder to shoulder with the resistance? You can gird yourself in the armor of righteousness, soldier. From this moment on, you are a proud member of the resistance. They have sent a scout prowling around the junkyard just behind our beloved town. You did? Well, color me impressed, soldier. Wish I had a dozen recruits with your gumption. You're a passing fair soldier, I will confess. But you are one, and the enemy is legion. What you need is an equalizer, a weapon to strike fear in their cold, mechanical hearts. Cantina, lavatory, behind one of the toilets. That's where I've kept it hidden all these years. Sharp, ain't it? The lavatory is the very last place a mechanical has need to enter. On the double, soldier! Don't want the bartender poking around in there with a mop.
You're not a big drinker, are you?
Town's been dark a while now. Could be a mechanical trying to sabotage us. Feast your eyes, soldier. This here is a genuine Spacer's Choice injury customizing unit, designed to deliver a lethal blast of electrical discharge. I call it the Hand of the Law. You ever want to see a mechanical flailing around like a grounded fish? You stick a couple thousand volts in its guts. With compliments from old Ludwig. There's a workbench right through this door. Attach that unit to your favorite weapon and go forth into glorious battle. Time's come for you to journey down into the black heart of the enemy's camp. I'm talking about the old geothermal plant. Unfortunately, the old plant lies outside my board-given jurisdiction. You'll need to get a passcode from the boss, Reed Thompson. You got pluck, kid. But no, can't risk having you go native. I need you to get us the brain of a mechanical. Well, not exactly a brain. Anatomically speaking, what we're looking for is a logic module. Bang up work, soldier. You're a credit to your uniform. Oh, well, that reminds me. Gotta look into getting us a uniform. So this is it, then. The key to humanity's victory over the mechanical hordes. I would reward you with the gratitude of the Resistance, but I'm guessing you want something tactile. So here's a couple bits for your trouble, and a little something to remember me by.
Some sort of freelancer?
Gosh, that's clear. I wish I could do that. Impressive. handle this. Look at us!
Hey, Miss Parvati. Come for a visit?
Not today. Just helping this lady.
Thank you.